Retirement of plant assets. Companies dispose of plant assets generally in three ways. One is retirement, which is just getting rid of an asset. The second is sale, where we sell it for some proceeds. And the third is through exchange, such as exchanging an older delivery van for a new delivery van. In this video, I'm just going to talk about the sale and the retirement of assets. So when we're accounting for the disposal of plant assets, there's two steps that we need to follow. The first thing we need to do is to update depreciation on that asset all the way up until the date of disposal. The second thing we need to do then is to record the actual disposal of that asset. So let's look at updating the depreciation. What you need to do is you need to check and see when depreciation was last recorded. It will be given to you in such a way that you can see when the last time they recorded the depreciation was. And then you need to do the journal entry just to prepare any additional depreciation until the date of disposal. So let's look at this example. On July 1, 2019, Green Company sells office furniture for $16,000 cash. The furniture originally cost $60,000, and as of January 1, 2019, it had accumulated depreciation of $41,000. So now we can see that depreciation had been recorded through January 1. They're disposing of the asset on July 1. So they tell us depreciation for the first 6 months of 2019 is $8,000. So we need to do the journal entry just for those first 6 months. So we're going to debit depreciation expense and credit accumulated depreciation. Now that we've updated the depreciation, we can record the disposal on the asset. So when you're recording the disposal, you need to determine the original cost of that asset, the total accumulated depreciation all the way up to that disposal date, the proceeds they received, if they received any at all, and then you'll need to calculate the gain or the loss on the disposal of that asset. So let's look a little bit more in depth at a sale. Here we have Green Company, the same information, and now we need to find all of those components. So the first thing we can find here is that our original cost was $60,000 for our equipment. And then they originally had accumulated depreciation of $41,000, but we've added on that additional $8,000 with that previous journal entry. So now the total depreciation is $49,000. Then lastly, we can see that they received $16,000 cash in proceeds for that sale. Now that we've identified the cost, the total depreciation, and the proceeds, we need to calculate the gain or the loss. When you're calculating the gain or the loss, you need to compare the book value of the asset to the proceeds that were received. Now remember, book value is the cost of the asset minus the accumulated depreciation. And if the proceeds that you receive are more than the book value, then you'll record a gain on the disposal. If the proceeds are less than the book value, then it's a loss on the disposal. So if we look at the office furniture, the original cost was $60,000 and total accumulated depreciation was $49,000, so the book value is $11,000. Since the proceeds were $16,000, in this case, the proceeds are more than the book value, so we end up with a $5,000 gain on the sale. So now we can go back to our information, add on that we have a $5,000 gain, and now we can build our journal entry on July 1. So we're going to debit cash for the $16,000 because we are receiving cash for that furniture. Debit accumulated depreciation for the $49,000 to remove the accumulated depreciation, and credit the equipment for the $60,000 to remove that equipment. And now lastly, we're going to credit our gain on disposal of plant assets. It's a credit because the gain is an other revenue. Now what if instead of selling the furniture for $16,000, they only sell it for $9,000? Well, now we need to go back and recalculate to see if we have a gain or a loss. So remember, our book value was $11,000 for our equipment. And now, since our proceeds are only $9,000, we end up with a $2,000 loss on the sale. So again, now we can build our journal entry. We're going to debit cash for the $9,000 they received, debit accumulated depreciation and credit the equipment to get rid of the equipment, and then we also are now going to debit that disposal on plant assets. And it's a debit because a loss on disposal is an expense. Now let's look at a retirement example. Sunset Company discards delivery equipment that cost $18,000 and has accumulated depreciation of $14,000. Okay, so our book value here is $4,000. And it told us they discarded it, so they have zero proceeds. They aren't receiving any cash on this asset. So we end up with a loss of $4,000 because we have zero proceeds compared to a book value of $4,000. And so now we can build our journal entry. We're going to debit accumulated depreciation to get rid of the depreciation. We're going to debit that loss because it's an expense and credit the equipment to remove the equipment from our books. Now, if the asset had been fully depreciated, meaning that the cost is equal to the accumulated depreciation, then there would be no gain or loss on the sale. You would just have the debit to accumulated depreciation and the credit to equipment. Okay, so in summary, there's a two-step process for disposal of a plant asset. The first thing you need to do is update depreciation all the way to the day of disposal, and that journal entry is usually a debit to depreciation expense and a credit to accumulated depreciation. And then you need to record the disposal itself. You're going to debit cash for the proceeds received. You're going to debit accumulated depreciation to eliminate that depreciation. You're going to credit the asset for its original cost. And then you're either going to have another debit for the loss on the sale or a credit on the gain. And these two last ones, the loss and the gain, it's an either or. You would never have both a loss and a gain in the same journal entry. Okay, I hope that clears up the disposal on plant assets for you.